immer noch nicht gezogen?
Das muss schneller gehen, Leute. Die Lea, okay. Gut, wir haben nur eine Lea, das heißt, sie dürfte sich schon mal auf den Weg machen. Ich werde allerdings euch ihren vollen Namen verraten, der wirklich auch sehr klangvoll ist. Hier ist Lea Moana Weiringer! Und ihr klatscht bitte, bis sie bei uns angelangt ist. Lea!
Hallo, herzlich willkommen zu meiner Rede. Ich würde heute gern mit euch meine Gefühle, Gedanken und Erlebnisse von meiner Reise teilen. Ich war ein halbes Jahr in Südostasien und Neuseeland und habe dabei wirklich sehr viele Eindrücke bekommen und wirklich sehr viel gelernt. Und es war mein Weg zum Glück und ich hoffe, ich kann heute mit euch meinen Weg zum Glück teilen. Happiness. Away for over 5 months now. A head full of memories, thrilling moments and people that have touched my soul. The only thing I do know for sure now is that I'm truly happy. But then I ask myself, what should that even mean, being happy? It seems like everybody seeks it, but just a few are happy enough to catch it and keep it. Back home, I actually had everything. The only thing missing was being happy with myself. I wish children would learn that in school nowadays. Instead of unnecessary numbers and names that they will forget anyways, that to learn that being yourself is already enough, that since day one they already have everything within themselves. Happiness, it's that feeling when you feel every cell of your body dancing, when you look at someone and just realize how much they mean to you and how much you love them. I realize that real happiness is all around me. It's not something huge, it's actually just the everyday joys all lined up. It's the rays of sun touching my skin, or it's swimming in the ocean, it's riding a wave, or riding on a motorbike, just having a coffee with a friend, or walking the street and smiling to a stranger. I also know now that you can't always be 100% happy every day in your life. And that's okay, but I do know that it all starts within yourself, because happiness is a choice, and it's just how you react to your circumstances. So life is gonna throw stones at you anyways. The only thing that you could really try is to always stay positive and find your way through happiness. At the end of the day, we should always be grateful. And the lack of happiness, in my opinion, shows us what gratefulness means and all the things we can be grateful for. The perfect life people seem to be living, it actually doesn't exist. No one has a perfect life. So happiness is not going to be the solution for all your struggles, but lack of happiness is going to teach you gratefulness, which is even more important. You don't appreciate what you have until it's gone, right? So hold on to the simple and happy moments, but also appreciate the bad moments, because these moments are the ones that are going to help you grow and help you be even more grateful. For sure, life is not going to be full of just thrilling adventures, as was my journey. But you can see good in your everyday life too, by just observing and seeing the beauty in every little detail. It's just hidden in people's smiles, flowers, walking the street, just watching the clouds pass by, or art. Happiness radiates, which means just by being happy yourself, you can help to make even the world a better place and more positive place. We're buying so much stuff nowadays, thinking that external things are actually going to solve our problems, make us more beautiful, worthy, or enough. But the actual key, in my opinion, is to go inside. Look inside for your key, because you already have it within yourself. The people who inspired me the most are probably the locals in Asia. One of the reasons why I wanted to travel through Southeast Asia was because even though they have nothing there, they seem to be more happy than all the people in the West. So I asked myself, how's that? Now I know. Because they live from day to day. They don't care how much they have, how much they own, or they don't care about the next vacation. They're just being so grateful for the basic life they have, for a good meal after a hard working day, for seeing their family, or just for being healthy. They're not too worried about all the external things as we are in the West. They're simply happy with what they have right now, right in this moment, right in front of them. So it's impressive to just live our lives and be grateful for the now, because actually now is all we ever have. We tend to worry too much about the past and the future, and I think that's because we're always fast forward. Our life just happens on fast forward. We never pause, stop, and just observe. So the past, that's what I'm telling you, and why worry about something that's actually out of your hands? You can't change it. And the future is always uncertain. That's what I actually love about the future. You're making all these plans up in your head, but at the end of the day, it always turns out completely different. And that's also good, because looking back, who can't tell that they're actually glad some things didn't happen the way they once wanted them to? When the bright future arrives, it's always different, right? So I'm glad some things didn't work out the way I once wanted them to. We have the power to do, feel, and say everything we want right in this moment. So all I'm trying to say is just say what you feel, hug that stranger, talk to that stranger on the street that seems interesting, and just try to move out of your comfort zone at least once a day. Because the message should be, wake up and try your best every day. Move out of your comfort zone, because that's the place where you're going to find even more happiness. Seek your dreams, and while doing so, give happiness the possibility to approach you. Be open, be kind, and positive, always, because you never know what battles other people fight. Just try, because you never know where your happiness may hide. Thank you.
Dankeschön, Lea Moana Weiringer. Was wir natürlich nicht getan haben, als wir die Jury ausgewählt haben, ist, sie auf Fremdsprachenkenntnisse zu prüfen. Ich hoffe, Sie haben den Text nachvollziehen können. Ansonsten gilt die übliche Slam-Regel: If you don't understand the poem, feel it. Was habt ihr gefühlt, liebe Jury, oder verstanden? Wir zählen wieder runter. 3, 2, 1. So. Wir beginnen mit einer 7,9 vom Tim. Springen auf die 8. So. Wir haben vom Team Marie eine 8,5. Janine zeigt die 8,9. Und zum Schluss haben wir eine 8,7. Wir streichen die 7,9 und die 9,7 und haben 25,4 Punkte für Lea Moana Weiringer. Applaus bitte.